Beautiful, how are you?
I'm good. Can you see me okay?
I can see you perfectly. What about me? Because you know how these things always adjust
I
when.
see you perfectly. Let's make sure the fans can see us well, too. I hope they can. You look so beautiful.
Oh, so do you. You look beautiful. I love
Thank
that
you.
eyeshadow.
Oh, thank you.
Like.
It's the only eyeshadow I know how to do. It's like this like pink thing that I rub on my eyes. It's great.
It's like natural but edgy. I love it.
Thank you.
So how have you been? Like, I haven't talked to you since like the beginning of quarantine. We're
I
still
can't believe it that literally in the beginning of quarantine we did this and I did the whole promo tour for I Love You and now we're doing it again for Guess I'm a Liar, which is so exciting, but that we're still here. It's unreal. I'm
but you know
good.
what? You have made it work. Your fans are here more than ever. You know, the funniest thing is last night I put up like, what questions do you have for Sophia? And I go to check them. And I'm like scrolling. Like they just don't end. It is unbelievable how much your fans love you.
Truly is. I'm so lucky and so grateful. And I feel so lucky that I get to, in the midst of all of this, share music with them, music that means something to me and that means something to them. And I'm just so excited that this kind of new era of music has begun and that they're reacting the way that they are and that we're all here together in some, crazy but really special way.
Absolutely. And your newest baby, Guess I'm a Liar. Oh my God. You just dropped that on Friday. And what are you feeling right now? It's so new.
It is. It's so new. I mean, even talking about it feels surreal because for so long it was like a secret that I had kept and that the anticipation was so high. And truly, we've worked so hard for this launch and every detail leading up to it, which is so exciting. It just makes everything that much more fulfilling when it's out for the world. I feel excitement. I feel happiness. I feel gratitude. I love this record so much. I can't wait for them to watch the music video on Friday. So yeah, overall, I would say it's really exciting.
Amazing. So I could go on and ask questions about the song, but there are so many questions that your fans have that they sent.
Yes.
Can we dive into a couple of those?
Of course.
Absolutely. Okay, so first question, what was the message or inspiration behind Guess I'm a Liar?
Great question. As my fans know, to me, it's all about storytelling and releasing music that tells a meaningful story. And I loved the story of Guess I'm a Liar because it's when we're in that moment when we've just had our heart broken and we believe with our whole heart that we genuinely can't live without him or her. And then we open our eyes and we realize that we're alive and that we choose to love ourselves better than he or she ever could. So I guess I was a liar when I said that I couldn't live without you. So it's like it's an anthem of heartbreak survival and the story of the triumph of self-love, but all kind of in the world of this really sick track and this kind of sassy line that's Guess I'm a Liar. So I love that about that, the contrast of it all.
You know what's crazy is when I'm listening to it, like I see it now from the angle that you just said, kind of like not thinking you can be without someone and realizing self-worth. Like for me, I listen to it and I'm like, oh, this just makes me want to forget about everything and go out and have fun and dance.
Exactly.
So I love that everybody can like get their own special meaning. What's
Exactly.
your favorite line in the song? Jerry wanted to know that.
Hi, Jeremy. My favorite line is "Promise I would love you till the day I die, but I'm still alive. So I guess I'm a liar." That line just, I remember as I was recording it, I said to myself, I can't wait for girls and guys all around the world to sing those lines at the top of their lungs.
And feel like free and empowered.
That's exactly, I remember when we were creating the visuals for the videos, like I want her, and I say her, but the character I was playing the video, me, I want her to feel empowered and happy and free, like she survived,
I love that. So,
Yeah.
what was the recording process like, especially in quarantine?
Yeah, well, this song actually was recorded pre-quarantine in the golden days.
Yes.
But I had an incredible truly incredible team of writers and producers that I was lucky to collaborate on with this record. Jason Evigan, Gion Stone. Gion did Stuck With You, Ari and Justin Bieber. Jason's done like all of Maroon 5. Carolyn Allen, who writes for Dua Lipa, really an incredible team. And it was just almost like an undeniable thing when I heard the record. I was like, oh, this is just such a powerful record, and recorded it. And here we are months and months later. And we're all so happy that it's out for the world.
Absolutely. Now, do you think that there's a couple fans that want to know if you're going to do a Guess I'm a Liar challenge on TikTok like you did for I Love You?
Perhaps. Actually, today I posted my first TikTok in I don't know how many years, and it was the teaser for the music video for Guess I'm a Liar. So yes, what I want is for fans to now start, you know, making their own creative versions of Guess I'm a Liar. And of course, once I see the choreography on Friday and the music video, I can't wait to see, you know, how creative they're going to get. They did such an amazing job with I Love You, and I can't even imagine with this record because it's such a dance record. So yes, I think they'll be happily surprised for what's coming.
Yay! Okay, cool. If you had to describe in one emoji your new music, what would it be?
Well, I've been using, because it's very true, emojis are very important to me because I feel like every song has like an emoji that's related to it. So I've been using like the thunderstorm and the lightning bolt for Guess I'm a Liar because that just feels really right for this song.
I love that. I love seeing like emojis that you don't see every day and then like bringing them to
life.
That's true. You know? Let's talk about the video. It's dropping on Friday.
Yes.
What was that like?
The video drops Friday. It was an incredible process to bring this story to life visually. I was so lucky to work with Hannah Lux Davis, who is an extraordinary director and one of the probably best pop directors of our time. And it was a full circle moment because she directed my first music video, Love is the Name, at the very beginning of my career. And to kind of come back with this new era of music, with my solo music, and to be able to do it with her was really special. And, you know, the visuals of a song are so important to me, and I would say probably to every artist, because it just tells a story. And I really wanted this song to be really visually striking. And she really accomplished that. She just immediately got it. And she fell in love with that lyric. That's my favorite lyric as well. Promise I would love you till the day I die. And she kind of, we tell the story of this empowered, free female in this heightened, really striking visual world. And there might be a couple of surprises here and there that they'll see in the video as well. But I'm really excited to release it on Friday.
Very exciting. And you're also going to be performing it live on Good Morning America.
I am. Friday's a big day. Performing Good Morning America. It's the world. I guess the first time I'll be performing the song ever for the world will be Friday morning. And then right after the music video drops. So it's really exciting.
That is exciting. So last time you were on Good Morning America, you did it virtually. Are they doing that as well? Or are you going to go on site for that?
This time it is virtually as well. GMA is not doing in-person things because of COVID yet. However, it's going to look different than the last time that I was on.
Oh, I'm so excited. So looking forward to it. And also you have a huge performance next Thursday, the 29th, where you'll be doing an exclusive show for your fans. What are you most excited about for that?
You know, this is from the bottom of my heart to theirs. This is dedicated to the fans who have been on this journey with me from the very beginning. So it's all for them. And it's a night that we can all be together and united through music. Even though we can't physically be together, we will be in spirit from every corner of the world. And it's a chance for me to perform some of my and their favorite songs that I've released. And of course, perform Guess I'm a Liar for them. So I'm really excited.
So exciting. Now, where are you going to be like filming the performance at?
In Los Angeles. It is at this beautiful stage in Los Angeles.
Oh, I can only imagine how beautiful it's going to be. Yeah. So exciting. And those tickets are free and available to anyone who would like to watch.
Correct? They are free. Absolutely. They are all for you guys. And I can't wait to be there with you.
You are so sweet for doing that. I love that.
Oh, of course. I'm so excited. It's the least I can do. Like you say, they're truly extraordinary. So I'm so grateful.
I will never be able to get over how you're amazing. It is incredible. But it goes back to you being the most authentic version of yourself. And it shows, you know, people
like
that.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
You're welcome. Of course. And also to everyone watching, we are here at WNCI going to be doing some meet and greet giveaways later on this week. So make sure to kind of keep watching on our stories and our feed and see how you can win a meet and greet with Sophia.
Yay.
Awesome. Okay, real quick, I want to talk about what you've been doing on the big screen because I am so proud of you.
Thank you.
I mean, I messaged you when Feel the Beat came out and I was like,
yeah, so sweet.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you. Honestly, it's been a whirlwind and I feel so blessed and so grateful. Feel the Beat was like our baby and we poured our hearts into that film and it was just a beautiful and really rewarding feeling to see the world fall in love with it. And there's something about seeing your face on Netflix that is something that, I don't know, I never calculated it in my mind, if that makes any sense. I was like, oh my, when I would turn on my Netflix, you know, to watch my shows and I would see like my face on Feel the Beat and like number two in the country or like,
yes,
you know, next to, you know, the shows that I watch all the time. And I was like, this is so surreal. And then I found out, I think it was like the number one or one of the most seen movies of the summer on Netflix, which is, again, thanks to everyone that is here with us today watching. And I'm just so happy that that story meant something to so many young girls and boys around the world. And yeah, it's been really exciting. And then right after that, I was so lucky to be able to shoot a movie during the pandemic, which is actually the first movie to ever shoot during the pandemic. And it's a Michael Bay film with Demi Moore and Bradley Whitford and KJ Apa, myself, incredible, incredible cast. And I can't wait for that to come out. And I can't wait to tell you guys more about that too.
So I kind of peeped around on the internet and found a little bit of info. You play a girl named Sarah.
Yes, I do. I play Sarah.
And it's a thriller. So how, I just feel like that's so different from like, you know, what we see you normally do. What
oh, yeah.
What do you expect from
it's
that?
It's definitely very different from anything that I've done before. Actually, for KJ and I both, it was an experience like nothing else because first of all, we were shooting during a pandemic about a pandemic. So it made everything like that much more real and raw for us. Because we were shooting during a pandemic, it wasn't your average movie set, right? It was a much more limited crew. Everyone is masked. We have to take, you know, big precautions, got tested daily. So there's always that element of fear, which is very present in the film. There's no hair and makeup. So it's the rawest you guys will ever see on camera. Essentially how you would imagine to be during quarantine. That's how my character is. That's how I was. And it's a drama thriller, I would say, because there is a really big, beautiful, traumatic, romantic element to the film. Of course, in the realm of the thriller, which is what we're all living, you know, it's scary at times, the times that we're living. However, at the end of the day, it is a story of hope. And that's why I fell in love with it so much. It's a story of the hope that we have to hold on to and that as a world, we are all holding on to.
Yeah, well, it's an incredible cast. I'm so, so looking forward to it. I saw rumors about 2021, so we will keep our eyes peeled.
We shall see.
We shall see. Awesome. Okay, and I really want to highlight the fact that you have been such an advocate for voting. And
yes,
you have encouraged and advocated for not only this generation, but all generations to get out there and vote. What is one thing that we could leave your fans with about the next 2 weeks leading up to the election and how important it is to, one, make a plan, and two, realize that their vote and their voice does matter?
It's like you were in my head because that was the next thing that I was going to say. you know, I feel that it is our duty, but more so than that, I'm also so inspired by what I see online from this generation of fans, not only my fans, but from this generation in general. When you see the stats and the statistics saying that, you know, this year, 28 million people have already voted as compared to 4 years ago, it makes me so proud and so happy to know that and to be a part of this generation that is truly making change and that recognizes the responsibility that we carry as young men and women who it is literally in our hands to shape the future of our country. And when you realize that, and you realize it's something as simple yet so monumental as voting, it's a no-brainer. Like, our vote is our voice, and we have to use it because your future, your children's future, your parents, your grandparents, all depends on us right now. So let's vote. I have my ballot right in front of me. As you guys know, I'm constantly sharing ways of, like you say, preparing to vote, whether it is in person if you want to, or you drop off your mail-in ballot, or you mail it in. But we have 2 weeks. So let's do this. Let's do this together. There's nothing more important right now.
Yeah. And thank you for using your platform of 16.8 million followers. I mean, it's seriously magical that you do that. So thank you so much.
Of course.
I'm going to leave you with this. We are going to be playing Guess I'm a Liar for the first time tonight on the night show.
I'm so excited. Please send me a video. Oh, I love
it. Absolutely. I will.
Perfect. Thank you. So sending you my love.
Sending you so much love and good luck and congrats for this Friday.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Bye. Have a good one.
Bye,
guys. Love you.
Thanks, guys, so much for watching. And like I said, you can listen to WNCI. Probably we're going to start the giveaways tomorrow, I'm assuming. Keep your eyes peeled, so you might be able to score a meet and greet with Sophia Carson. If you don't live in the area, you can always listen on your smart speaker just by telling Google or Alexa to play 97.9 WNCI on iHeartRadio. Thank you, thank you, thank you to all of you who joined. There were so many of you. It was so much fun. And as always, Sophia is just a beam of light. So thank you so much for being here.